Hello, beautiful humans, and welcome back to another episode of Daily J. I'm so excited that you're here. If we haven't met before, it's amazing that you're here. I'm super, super grateful that you've shown up for this video, and I'm just super excited to deliver some epic content for you today. I'm gonna look this way because I always forget to look at the camera. I'm so sorry. It always looks like I'm looking at myself in the reflection, which I kind of am. P.S. Have the beautiful pool in the background today, so I'm hoping you can enjoy some greenery. No, I'm not in Hawaii already. I've still got 3 more weeks on the Gold Coast before we head over to Hawaii for a beautiful family holiday. I'm so freaking excited to just switch off for 3 weeks. I feel like I've been go, 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 working 7 days a week, just like little bits and pieces every single day that's sort of adding up over the long term. So I'm so excited just to have some time off, completely shut off except for posting on social media and responding to the beautiful girls in my ISA tribe. I'm so excited to just have some relaxation time with my beautiful family and just explore Hawaii and all that the beautiful island has to offer us. I just have the feeling, I just know I was there for a really brief stopover on my way back from the States and like just a couple of days ago, and I just, as soon as we landed, I just got that beautiful sense of like mother energy just completely surrounding and enveloping me. And I just felt like it was kind of similar to when you land in Bali. If anyone's ever been, you kind of get that immediate sense of like sigh of relief and just like that immediate feeling of being connected to the earth and mother nature. And I just felt that as soon as that we touched down in Hawaii, but like magnified tenfold. So I know already, I've downloaded already, that this is just going to be the most incredible, intense, beautifully intense trip, and we, the three of us, are just going to come away feeling completely energized, inspired, and so taken care of, like so unbelievably taken care of by our beautiful Mother Earth and this beautiful mother energy that we're so grateful and so privileged to be able to explore. So super excited, and please stay tuned. This week, or today, I want to talk about the power of perspective. And this is just coming off the back of my LA trip. For those of you that don't know, I've been living there for the last 3 months. I've just gotten back to Australia, and one of the things that keeps coming up, everyone keeps asking how my trip was and, you know, what was my favorite part and all these different things. And what keeps coming up for me in the wake of that question, or in response to that question, is this incredible power that we have to choose our perspective. So I have two choices when answering that question. I can talk about how challenging it was. I can talk about how difficult it was. I can talk about how there were places when I didn't know if I was going to have anywhere to stay, or I didn't know where I'd be staying that night. There were times when I didn't know where my next meal was coming from. There were times when I was, you know, scared or afraid, or in situations where it was like pretty dangerous. Or I could focus on the incredible encounters that I had with divine, like-minded humans. I can talk about the incredible miracles that I experienced in the wake of stepping out in faith. I can talk about the incredible blessings that were showered on me every single freaking day of the trip, because I open myself up to receive them. And it's like, it's not that the experience was all good or all bad, but my perspective on it completely changes the quality or the story that I tell about the trip. So it's like I get to choose, because the trip was both. Like, our lives are both. The story is always both. There's good elements, there's bad elements. There's things that work out the way we wanted them to, and there's things that don't. Our power lies in our ability to choose the perspective from which we view it. So I can sit there and focus on all the terrible things. I can sit there and focus on all the times that I was challenged and crying and upset and emotional. Or I can just as easily focus, or not always just as easily, but just as quickly, focus on all of the beautiful good things that came out of the trip, all of the beautiful experiences, all of the beautiful people that I met, all of the beautiful songs that I listened to, like the soul awakenings that I experienced. And it's like the trip was both. The trip was both the hardest thing that I've ever done and the best decision I've ever made. But my power lies in my ability to choose which parts of the trip and which experiences that I want to focus on. Which parts do I want to speak about? Which stories do I want to tell? What kind of message do I want to deliver to the world through this experience that I've had? I have an opportunity every time that I speak to someone about this trip, and this is the exact same opportunity that is granted to you every time someone asks you a question about absolutely freaking anything. You have been granted an opportunity to either spiral downwards into fear and bring the other person with you, or rise up into love. You have that opportunity to focus on the negative. You have the opportunity to focus on what sucked. You have the opportunity to focus on all the shitty things, or you also, and or you also have the opportunity to bring that person with you into your beautiful love bubble, to invite them higher into your vibration, your energy, wherever it is that you're living out or vibing out at the time, and inspire them to take their own action, to take their own leap of faith, to do whatever it is that they've been really wanting to do. Because you guys know this trip has been on my heart for so freaking long, for almost 6 months. And I know that whenever I speak about this, whenever I have the opportunity to talk to someone about the trip, whenever I have the opportunity to share my experiences, I'm also in that moment being granted the opportunity to inspire out of someone else to go and take their own big leap, to go and manifest their own desires, to go and do the thing, to take the risk that they've been longing to take. And so it's like, I take that incredibly seriously, and I take that responsibility to heart, because to me it's like, what greater privilege is there than that, than inspiring others with your message and using your story to spread light wherever you go. So I wanted to jump in really quickly today with this beautiful reminder of how much power you have to choose the perspective that you look from. Always, 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 always. Are you going to focus on what sucked? Are you going to focus on what was negative? Are you going to focus on what didn't work out the way you wanted it to, even though it was really, really, really like soul, you thought it was soul determined? Or are you going to focus on what did? Are you going to focus on what really worked really freaking well? On the things that came together so perfectly that you can't even freaking fathom how amazing it all, like how much God loves you and how amazing it all was. And watch, in the wake of that focus, those things expand in your reality. Because we all know, you guys, what you focus on expands. So wherever you choose to put your focus, whichever perspective you want to put your power behind, whichever lens you want to look through, the choice is totally yours. But please, please, please always remember the power that you have in choosing. I love you guys so freaking much. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time on Daily J. Mwah.